observe, kind of focus on as we go through this process is that we want to look at the system as a whole. So we really want to look very comprehensively in a big picture way at the entire system of waste management in Ohio. We're committed to a very open and transparent process, so we want everybody to have an opportunity to participate. Waste management touches a lot of different interested parties, whether that be the waste industry, the private waste industry, the public waste industry, Ohio EPA, health departments, cities, townships, citizens, and there are many others that are kind of involved. So we want everybody to have an opportunity to participate. We're seeking consensus as we move forward. So there's a lot of different issues out there, and we are going to try to find some consensus as we move forward. And our real focus is to make the system as efficient and effective as possible. We also aren't afraid to think big. So we're not, obviously our point of reference is House Bill 592 and the way that things operate currently. But we really aren't afraid to rethink the whole thing. If there are some good ideas out there, if there are some other states that are doing things differently, we're not afraid to put anything on the table and everything on the table. We are going to be proceeding through a four-step process, and I'm going to go into some detail on each of these. But a four-step process that starts with information gathering, going to some discussion and consensus building. We're going to come with a formal proposal for folks, and then there'll be a formal legislative initiative at the end of the process. So we're in phase one of the process right now, which is the information gathering stage. As part of this process, we've invited all the interested parties to come sit down with Ohio EPA. Our focus is just to gather information and to understand what are the interests of different individuals, what are the things that they think are working, what are the things that they think aren't working, what do they think are the most important issues, and just to kind of frame the discussion by understanding where people, where their focuses are right now. We have put out invitations to all the obvious interested parties, and I've got a list of those that I'm going to show you in a second. We also have an open invitation to anybody that wants to come down, that wants to sit down with us and share their thoughts. We really started this phase of the process in December, and we're, full bore into it in March, and it'll extend into April, possibly May of this year. The obvious interested parties from our perspective are the SWATA, which is the Solid Waste District Association, which is part of the County Commissioners Association of Ohio, the National Solid Waste Management Association, and the Solid Waste Association of North America, the health departments, which are represented by OEHA and AOHC, the Ohio Municipal League, which represents cities, the Ohio Township Association, the Ohio Chamber of Commerce and the Manufacturers Association, which represent Ohio businesses, the Sierra Club and the Ohio Environmental Council, which represent Ohio's environmental groups, AOR, which is the Association of Ohio Recyclers, ODNR, which is our sister agency when it comes to the recycling policy issues, and SWAC members. SWAC, if you're not familiar with the term, is the Solid Waste Advisory Council. It's a state-level advisory council that provides advice to Ohio EPA on solid waste issues. So those are the interested parties that we have specifically reached out to. But as I indicated before, we are putting an open invitation to everybody who is interested in participating or have some ideas or thoughts on waste management in Ohio. The other thing that I think is important is that we've done our formal invitations to these trade organizations, but any individual member of the organizations also have an invitation to sit down with us. So, for instance, our invitation is to the County Commissioners Association. Any individual county is also welcome to come meet with us and share their thoughts, and that goes the same is true with the waste industry, the health departments, and so forth and so on. So we're reaching out to the trade organizations, but individual members are welcome and invited and encouraged to come share their thoughts with us. At the conclusion of the formal sit-down meetings, informal sit-down meetings, we will be reporting to our state, our SWAC, which I just mentioned, our State Solid Waste Advisory Council. to let them know what kind of things we've heard from these individuals. And again, this is just kind of to help folks frame the issues, to help us frame the issues, understand what's most important and on people's minds. Phase two of the process will be a discussion and consensus building phase. We'll actually have facilitated group discussions where we invite the interested parties to come together and to share their thoughts directly with one another, and we'll have some facilitated discussion. This is where we're going to really be trying to dig into the issues a little bit more deeply and really seek consensus. We may have some issue-specific meetings as well. Some of those interested parties have a very fairly limited or focused kind of interest, and since we're going to be looking at at all aspects of waste management, there may be some individual meetings where we just focus on one or two topics. Those meetings will be scheduled in April to June, maybe July, maybe August of this year. And again, we'll kind of work through those. Those will be publicly, obviously public meetings that anybody can participate in. And when we're done with that phase of the process, we will report back to SWAC once again in terms of what kind of progress we made, what kind of issues were discussed, and so forth. Phase three of the process will be Ohio EPA developing and issuing draft recommendations based on both of those first two phases of the process. We will be seeking input from SWAC prior to finalizing our proposal. And once it's finalized, it will be issued as a draft proposal for all interested parties to comment on. So one of the messages that we're trying to get across here is that there are going to be multiple steps in the process where people can provide input and participate. So once we get a draft recommendation that's going to be put out for formal public comment, people will have another opportunity to comment on our proposal, and then we will finalize that proposal. The final step in the process will be a legislative process where we will seek a legislative sponsor and pursue these legislative changes through the legislature. And then once again, people can participate, obviously, through the legislative process. This entire process should take a good year, probably a year and a half when all is said and done. We hope to pursue a proposal jointly with interested parties. So we would love to be able to move forward with the industry, the health departments, the solid waste districts, the environmental organizations, so forth and so on. We would hope that we would have multiple interested parties where we could move together seeking a legislative proposal. Having said that, while we're seeking consensus, the process won't be dependent on it. So, we will move forward ultimately with a proposal from Ohio EPA with or without consensus on all of the issues. We also are kind of reserving the right to take two bites at the issue. So we know that there is the real potential for some difficult issues where we could have, controversy on what direction to move forward on. So it's very possible that we may move forward on a consensus-driven agenda and say, there are a couple really controversial issues that we want more time to work on. So we may move forward with a consensus proposal and hold back on some of the controversial issues and work on those a little bit more before we move forward on those. We, meaning Ohio EPA, obviously have some ideas. We've been in the middle of implementing House Bill 592, in the middle of waste management for over 20 years. We've got some ideas. But at this stage, we are really just holding back and really being very focused on just trying to gather information, work with the interested parties to understand where they're coming from. So even though we have ideas, we really have very few preconceived notions in terms of what we're going to move towards and where we're going to go with this. We are just in the listening stage right now. There are just a couple fundamental principles that are kind of guiding us. Obviously, no matter what is done in terms of waste management in Ohio, it has to be protective of human health and the environment. I think that's kind of a no-brainer that kind of underlies all of our understandings of waste management. And one of the issues that was right in 592, that was kind of central to 592, that continues to be very true today, is that we need to continue to reduce our reliance on landfills for the management of solid waste. There are better environmental options than landfilling, and we need to continue to move towards those options. We know that there are some big picture issues that have really always been on people's minds from the day that 592 was passed. Solid waste fees are always kind of on the forefront of people's mind. They're always controversial. Flow control has always been controversial. But there have been some proposals out there on regionalization of solid waste management districts, and that's, you know, just a big issue in government in general, shared services and so forth and so on. So we know that those issues are out there and are likely to be addressed during this process. But those may not be the only ones. I just want to conclude now with talking about how you can stay involved in the process. The first thing that I'd like to do is show you our website that we have developed for this process. On Ohio EPA's web page, we now have a website devoted to House Bill 592 review. It can be found, if my mouse will work, which it doesn't always like to work, right down here on the little gutter on the left-hand side of the web, on all the web pages on Ohio EPA's website, you'll find learn more about, and there's one called Solid Waste Management Review. If you click on that, you're going to get to this Solid Waste Management Review webpage. It's a little bit of background about 592, talked a little bit about why we're going to review it, and then it actually goes through this four-step process that I just talked about. Today's presentation, we have a version of this presentation that's posted right here, and today's actual presentation will be posted there shortly. And then for each phase of the process, we have a separate page. So at this stage, we're in phase one. It talks about how you can get involved by scheduling a meeting with Ohio EPA. When we move into phase two, it will talk about the meetings that we have scheduled, and there will be a calendar that's posted right here. Right now, the only thing on that calendar is today's webinar, but as we move into the months ahead, we will have the meetings scheduled there on that calendar. As we get into phase three, this will obviously be the place where we'll post the draft proposal, and so forth and so on. We also have documents posted at the bottom of the webpage. These are going to be updated all the time. We've just probably today or tomorrow on Monday, we'll have some additional documents posted. But as we get some background information and kind of that kind of thing, we'll get those posted at the bottom of the page here. So our webpage is really the primary method that we're going to utilize to communicate with folks. You got an invitation to today's webinar from Christopher Germain. His name is listed right here as his phone number and web address and his email address. So if you have any questions during the process, please call Christopher Germain, and he can help you out. Let me flip back to the presentation. At this stage, we are going to start maybe addressing any questions that people have. And I don't know. I'm looking over here to Chris. Okay. So right now, it looks like we've only had one message sent to us. And it looks to me, it says, can, I think, Pennsylvania businesses participate on Ohio SWAC? Not totally, and so it's from Michael Pavlik. So, Michael, please send us another message if I had that question wrong. But the question is, can Pennsylvania businesses participate on SWAC? SWAC members are appointed by the governor of Ohio, and we, Ohio EPA, makes a recommendation to the governor's office, and then ultimately the governor's office appoints them. The answer is, I don't know that there's anything legislatively, legally, that would prevent us from appointing somebody from Pennsylvania, but I don't think we would do that because SWAC is focused on waste management in Ohio. Those meetings are public meetings, however, and we invite people all the time to speak from a national audience. So we have folks from, Alcoa or, various businesses associated with recycling and waste management. we have them come to SWAC all the time to present. So you can certainly participate in SWAC if you're from out of state. So at this, you know, at this stage, you could raise your hand through the process, or you can ask us a question on the chat. I've got a question from Gregory Patterson. It says, will this effort touch on either infectious or hazardous waste components of solid waste? That's a great question. 592 is focused on solid waste, but it also defines what that is. So we really are open to dealing with waste streams that are closely affiliated with, we're potentially interested in dealing with waste streams that are closely affiliated with solid waste. So it could conceivably touch on infectious waste, for example. The only thing that's really off the table is hazardous waste. Hazardous waste is governed and regulated by federal hazardous waste regulations. And so we are not going to get into the hazardous waste issues, but potentially we could get into infectious waste issues or other similar waste streams that are closely connected to solid waste. So that's a great question, Greg. Rick Kenner, you raised your hand. We just unmuted you, so if you can ask a question, please give it a shot.
Yeah, I was curious, will House Bill 592, the current bill, be posted on the website?
Yes, that's another great question. House Bill 592 has been amended many, many, many times since it was passed in 88. So we are actually intending to post the actual 592 that was passed back in 1988, but it's going to be out of date. So, yes, good question. We're going to do that, but also keep in mind that we're not, you know, it's a little bit narrow in terms of what we want to address in the sense that we really want to just address waste management in general, but we will definitely post 592 on the website. Yeah. The other thing that we'll do is we're going to post some links to the current version of the statute. You know, House Bill 592 was then incorporated into Ohio Revised Code, and there were certain sections of the Revised Code. So we will definitely also link to the current sections of the Revised Code and our rules that flowed from the Revised Code as well. So there'll be a lot of links to the appropriate, relevant statutory and regulatory provisions. So I'm just going to give you just a couple more minutes here. Just a reminder that if you're going to send a message, send it to Cindy Kerr, who is the host, when you send a chat message. Or you can raise your hand, and again, you just go to the top of your screen. You should have a green bar. You should be able to pull down some tools at the top. That should allow, and there's a chat button then. It allows you to chat and send us a message, and there's a button that says participants, that if you open that up, you will be able to raise your hand. So we have so many people on the line, and so many people on that I'm just surprised that there aren't more questions. Here's a couple more. Okay, Neil Drobny from AOR asked us a question. It says, how will House Bill 592 process be integrated with the Senate Bill 290 proposal? For those of you that are not familiar with Senate Bill 290, it was a recent piece of legislation that was introduced that dealt with solid waste management districts. It dealt with the definition of solid waste and source hazardous recyclables, and it put some prohibitions on solid waste districts' expenditures for recycling activities. We are hoping, Neil, to move that. The agency has not made taken a formal position on 290 yet, but we have definitely expressed concerns about it because of one of our concerns is that we have this 592 review process underway. So we would like to move that bill into the 592 process. We're working with the interested parties right now to see if we can do that. So we're not. It's very much the kind of thing that we don't want to see. We don't want to see this kind of piecemeal legislation, and we're working actively to move it back into the 592 review process. Michelle Nestor has also asked a question. Michelle Nestor says, US EPA is currently reconsidering the definition of what is a waste in general. Will this process be exploring a similar avenue? This process could explore that question, Michelle. It's not on our short list. I mean, it's not a specific intention of ours to say, hey, we want to reconsider what is and isn't a solid waste, but the definition of what is and isn't a solid waste is central to everything that we do, so it's a natural question to be asked at this stage in the game. So we're open, for sure, to that, to exploring that idea. Steve Vinnie has asked, as part of the revision of House Bill 592, will Ohio EPA be opening up certification training to organizations like SWANA? SWANA, for example, has been accepted as a certification training for landfills in 16 states. That's really an entirely separate issue from the 592 review. There is a requirement in the statute for certification of owners and operators of landfills and health departments and so forth. It's been there for a long time. The question of whether we need certification could definitely be on the table, but who does the certification really is running a separate track at this stage. Doug Evans, hi Doug, I haven't heard from you in a long time, so ask the question, when do you anticipate moving to phase two of the process? Phase one is going to run through March, April kind of time frame. We had hoped to kind of wrap up phase one in March and April, but I could see it running somewhere into April or May. So we'll be moving into phase two, I would say, in May would be the most likely date, no later than May. But monitor the website, because that's going to keep everybody on track in terms of where we're at. Mark Case asked, will the agency consider moving the omnibus bill 294 into this legislation? Nope. The answer is no, we will not. The omnibus bill deals with a wide variety of environmental issues that Ohio EPA deals with, not just solid waste, but a whole host of other environmental issues that have nothing to do with solid waste. So the omnibus bill is its own animal, and it's going to move forward as its own vehicle. Chris Walker asks, says, Cindy, I missed the discussion of step one. If it hasn't already been explained, how many parties have you met with in step one, and summarize who you've met with? We've actually, Chris, we haven't met with many folks in step one yet. We've had some informal discussions with a couple of solid waste management districts. We have had some very preliminary discussions with the waste industry. We have a lot of invitations out there right now. We're in the process of nailing down those meetings. To be honest with you, and I've been a little bit surprised by this, but a lot of folks have had trouble. A lot of folks have needed some time to work with their trade organizations to come up with their ideas. And that makes perfect sense. We didn't anticipate it at the time we started the process. So a lot of the interest parties have requested a little bit of a delay before they come and meet with us. So we are full into it here in March and April. We're going to start meeting with a lot of folks. But so far we haven't had many meetings. Okay. So I think at this stage we've hit all the questions that we've had. We're going to scan real quick. We have a long list of participants. Was there one? Okay. We've got a long list of participants. I don't see any more questions coming in on the chat. Oh, Dan Weisenbach has a question. It says, do the revisions include the continuation of community recycling grants, recycling market development grants, and litter prevention grants? So Dan is referring to ODNR grants that are given through an ODNR grant program that support recycling activities in Ohio. 592 really didn't deal with the ODNR program that issues grants. So again, it wouldn't necessarily be an issue that we would deal with directly. However, the broader, just thinking big picture, that it is part of our system in Ohio of how recycling is funded, both from, the processors, the market development side of things, and the community side of things. So in the sense, in the context of looking at the system, how is recycling funded in Ohio, it could definitely be a topic that somebody could bring forward. So it's not on our list necessarily, but somebody could, I could see definitely how it could be brought forward. Michelle Nestor has a question about Marcellus shale drilling, and she points out that it produces a lot of waste. How will the oil and gas industry figure into the groups of interested parties? Well, you know, you're right. That's kind of an emerging issue right now is the fact that we're seeing increases in drilling waste coming to landfills in Ohio, and we anticipate seeing increases in the future. That will potentially have impacts on landfill capacity, as well as fees that are generated from those materials. And there are, you know, questions being raised about the appropriate way to manage those materials. Our invitation on the 592 process is to everybody, and so we're not specifically anticipating reaching out to the oil and gas industry at this stage. But as that issue continues to evolve over the next few months, we may see the need to do so, and certainly since we have an open invitation, if they feel the need to reach out to us, you know, we would be all ears as well. Jim Patuch asks, will funding for boards of health be included in the discussion of 592 in terms of appropriate ranges for funding? I'm starting to repeat myself at this point. We're looking big picture in terms of how the system works. And the system works with a lot of different entities involved. Ohio EPA is involved, health departments are involved, solid waste districts are involved, others are involved as well. So the question of how different parties are involved, including health departments, solid waste districts, and Ohio EPA, certainly is a good question to ask, an appropriate question to ask, and how those individuals are funded is a good question and appropriate question to ask. At this stage in the game, you know, we are in an information gathering stage, so if people want to bring that issue forward, have ideas on that, they should bring it forward, and we'll deal with that. Michael Pavlik asks, fees on landfills. Will fees be charged only on landfills, or will incinerators also be charged on the incoming tonnage? The concern is that rural areas don't pay a disproportionate fraction of the fees. That's a little bit too specific of a question, really. Fees will be addressed. I don't want to have to spend the time to explain how fees are charged on incinerators versus landfills, et cetera, et cetera. Those kind of questions will certainly be asked. Those kind of questions will be addressed. Certainly one of the things that we're seeing over time is an evolution in how waste is managed. We're seeing, you know, new types of facilities, anaerobic digesters, conversion technologies, waste energy facilities. How fees apply to those different facilities is a great question and the kind of thing certainly that we will be wanting to look at. Neil Drobny asks, will you be benchmarking relevant practices in other states? Certainly. We're in constant contact with Region 5 states in particular, but we are always looking elsewhere as well. So we will be very interested in benchmarking with other states, how other states are handling some of these issues, and that will be part of our active research, certainly. But we are encouraging other folks that are in the field to bring up some of those other states to us. I mean, so if you're familiar with how things are done in other states and you think that they have a good approach, we're asking all interested parties certainly to bring those kind of ideas to us. Even if it's just to say, hey, have you looked at this state and how they handle that issue? Even if you're not an expert necessarily on exactly how they do it, but you think that they have approached it a little differently than Ohio, we think that we've got a pretty good handle on particularly the Midwest region, but there are obviously 50 states, and, you know, bring it to our attention if you have a thought in terms of other states. We may be about done. One last call for questions. I'm going to scan real quick to see if anybody has their hand raised. Okay. I think we're good. We really appreciate your participation. Have some great questions. One more. Neil has another question. Is extended producer responsibility within the scope of issues you will look at? If you're not familiar with the concept, extended producer responsibility is an idea where policies are put in place that require the generators of products to have more responsibility on how they're managed at the end of their life. E-waste legislation that a lot of states have is a good example of extended producer responsibility approaches. Certainly, that's the kind of thing that is kind of an evolving approach, and that is very much the kind of issue that I think is appropriate for discussion. So that's definitely within the realm of what we might look at. We don't see any other questions right now, but that certainly if they come up, by all means, give Christopher Germain, and shoot him an email, give him a call. One of the things that we're going to do, we've already got one queued up that we're going to post on our webpage, is we'll have some frequently asked questions. So if you've got some questions that we hear repeatedly, we will make them into a frequently asked question and post them on the webpage. But don't be shy. Just pick up the phone, call Christopher, send him an email. We'll get your questions answered. It's going to be a long process. It's going to be very interesting. As I said at the beginning, we know that there are a lot of different folks involved in waste management in Ohio. We very much encourage you to be involved in this process, bring your best ideas forward. We encourage everybody to have an open mind because we know that there's a lot of different angles on these things. So we're encouraging everybody to have an open mind, come at it with a consensus-driven kind of idea. Let's see if we can come together, work through some of these issues, and improve the way waste is managed in Ohio. So thank you once again to everyone, and hopefully we'll see you in the future as we move through this process.